Tem um melão, né?
Tchau, boiama.
Sai!
Yo, what's going on, people? And today I want to tell you about a hidden gem that I found called Brawlhalla. This is an indie free-to-play 2D platform fighting game. I repeat, Brawlhalla is free-to-play. The game is currently available on PS4, PC, and Mac. No Xbox, unfortunately. Now, when it comes to gameplay, this game falls under the category of easy to pick up, but it's hard to master. There are no long combos that you have to memorize, square, down, triangle, up, left, right, R2, none of that. They keep it very simple. It's either up, down, left, right, plus your light attack or your heavy attack, and there's only one combo, and that's to hit your light attack 3 times, and that's it. Now, the game does play kind of similar to Smash Brothers. Gadgets and weapons drop. The more damage you take, you are easier to knock off the stage, but I actually like this better than Smash Brothers. Yep, I said it. So let's get into some stuff that I like about this game. First of all, there are over 30 characters in this game, or legends, as the game like to call it, and they all play differently. Everyone has the same moves, but they have different variations of the same moves. What I mean is, if you press up on the heavy attack, this is going to initiate an uppercut. With certain characters, you have to be directly below the person, and another character, you have to be at a 45 degree angle. And this is where the hard to master the game part comes in, because every character is different. They all have different attack ranges, different attack speeds. So once you learn a character and you get accustomed to timing their attacks and how far they can attack, the game starts to get really fun and also pretty competitive. There are about 8 different types of weapons in the game, and each character comes with 2, so that's 2 sets of moves that you have to learn for every character. Now, as soon as you start playing the game, there are going to be about 5 or 6 characters available for you to play with, and these change in rotation every week. So you get a chance to play with all different types of characters, but in case you go through the character list and you see a character that looks cool and you want to buy them, before you buy each character, you can actually go into the training mode and try them out to see if you like them or not. So this way you don't have to blindly spend the money that you earned and buy a character and then hope that you like them. Now, you can just go and try out every single character until you find one that you like, so you know you're making the right purchase. Now, I also give credit to the game for going the extra mile and including a backstory for each and every character, and the backstory is also pretty cool. Some of the characters know each other and explains how each of them ends up in Brawlhalla. Now, when it comes to buying characters, the prices range between 34, 39, and 5400 coins. On average, you get around 40 coins for coming first place in a match. Now, that sounds like a lot of grinding, and I hate grinding in games, but the game is actually fun, so it doesn't seem like grinding. And second thing is, you actually get a lot of coins for, well, pretty much doing anything. There's a daily login bonus. The more consecutive days you log in, the more coins you get. You get coins for completing the tutorials, you get coins after every match, leveling up your overall level, and then you get coins for leveling up your characters in general. There's also 2 daily missions and something called Brawl of the Week, where it's a different type of game mode, and you have to win twice and you'll get around 300 coins. There's also a decent amount of customization in this game. You can change your character's colors, their weapon skins, the robot that brings you back up every time you get knocked off the stage, and you can also change the character's stances. These stances actually affect their stats, so you can change them to suit your playstyle. You can either increase your damage, how fast you attack, your mobility, and you can also up your defense so you don't get knocked off as easily. Now, seeing that this still is a free-to-play game, you unlock most of these things from just leveling up your character, but you're gonna have to pay real life money if you want the customizations, such as the weapon skins or the different types of character skins. And the last thing that I really love about this game is something that's been missing throughout this entire generation of games: local multiplayer. Ah yes, local multiplayer is alive and well in this game. You can have up to 8 people in the same room playing this game at the same time. You can create your own custom game room and actually switch it up. So say you can have 3 friends over by you, and another 4 friends can actually join that same game room through the online menu. And you also can take 1 person online with you, whether they're an online friend or if they're right next to you. You can either go online with the free-for-all, or you can play it 2v2. There are also different game modes that you can play when you're in the custom game room. You can have snowball fights, there's actually football, you can play dodgeball, basketball, and volleyball. Well, the game's version of these real life sports, but they're all fun nonetheless. My friends and I have been playing this game pretty much every day for the last 2 weeks for hours. This game is pretty fun. Now, onto some things that I actually don't like about this game. Having 8 people playing at the same time is all great, but it's not so great when you actually can't tell who you are. It's extremely easy to lose your character when all these players are on screen at the same time. And that's even when you put your name above your head. Like, your name doesn't stand out. It's just white. It's just the first three letters of your online name. I think they should either change your font color or add a thick black outline to those words, so it's pretty easy to realize who you are once the fighting starts. Hell, I would even take a big red circle floating over my character that just says the word you. The second thing I don't like is the distribution of coins. You get coins after every match, and of course if you come first you get the most amount of coins, but it seems like the longer the match is and the more people are in the match, that's when you will get the biggest payout. And here's a problem. I will get more money from playing a custom game mode with 7 of my friends than when I'm playing ranked. Ranked matches don't even last half as long as those big matches, and I only got like 19 coins versus the 70 coins I got from playing free-for-all with 7 other people. Playing ranked gives you a different currency at the end of the season, so you can buy more stuff in the store. However, I still think playing ranked should give you more money than playing casual or a custom game mode with your friends. And the last thing is that characters who have a spear or the rocket lance are extremely easy to spam because the range is so big. They could just keep pressing the heavy attack and stay in the same spot, and they can hit you if you get too close. It's avoidable, but it's still annoying nonetheless. So here's a quick recap in case you weren't paying attention. And on the side of pros, the game is free, it's fun, and it's easy to learn. Tons of characters, lots of ways to get money so you can buy more characters, and there's also character customization. And on the side of cons, it's extremely easy to lose yourself once a lot of fighting starts happening on screen. You don't get that much money from ranked, and characters who have spears and rocket lances are extremely easy to spam. And that's been my review of Brawlhalla. Again, the game is free to play, and I highly recommend you go and give it a try. If you enjoyed the video, you could leave a like, and if you're new here, you can check out my other playlist with more reviews, and there's plenty of other content on the channel that I think you might like, so you can subscribe and stick around. But that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.